What's better than a scoop of ice cream? How about an entire jar, completely customizable and only for you? And you can make it with basically no equipment and entirely in the jar. We've been tinkering with a no-churn ice cream recipe this entire summer and finally have a recipe we're so excited to share. A cookies and cream ice cream made entirely in a jar. First, make your base. Mostly heavy cream, a dash of whole milk, some white sugar, and vanilla extract, or you could do mint extract, chocolate syrup. This is the place to customize. From here, you can either mix by hand by shaking the jar vigorously for 5 to 7 minutes, or you can take the slightly lazier and, to be honest, more efficient route of using a hand mixer. We're obsessed with this mini cordless one that fits in the jar perfectly. Not sponsored yet, but as always, check out our link below to get it on Amazon. Mix until the mixture is noticeably thicker and has increased in volume, about the texture of whipped cream, which was a lot easier to get by the hand mixer, not as easy for mixing by hand, but you can get pretty close. Then place in the freezer for 2 hours so it mostly freezes, but not entirely, so you can still add in your mix-ins. Crumble up some Oreos in the plastic bag, mix them in. You could also do other cookies or add-ins. This is the place to totally tinker and explore. And then put it back in the freezer to fully freeze for another hour or so, but you can also just store it in the freezer until you're ready to eat it. We did so much tinkering, not only to get this base recipe, but then also explore with different flavors. So here's what we learned. First, those Oreos were key for flavor and texture. Without them, the vanilla didn't really have enough oomph, and it tasted mostly like frozen whipped cream. Lesson learned, add in some sort of mix-in. Stirring in things like cookies, chocolate, toffee at the end is a really easy way to play with different flavors, but we also wanted to see if we could play around with the flavor of the base itself. We tried out a coffee flavor by taking our base, heating it just slightly, and adding coffee grounds to infuse and steep the flavor in it. Straining out the coffee grounds actually required a good amount of troubleshooting. The first time, we let the mixture fully cool down and infuse in the fridge overnight, but that was way too thick to actually strain out. The second time, we didn't let it cool, but it still was having difficulty straining out. So the third time, we put the coffee grounds into the strainer and then put the whole strainer inside the milk mixture, let that steep for about 5 minutes, and then removed it. That did the trick. At the end, we added chocolate syrup and Oreos to make a mocha cookies and cream. We also tried a fruity vegan batch using coconut milk, frozen mango, and passion fruit. Seemed like a great idea, but the final texture was quite icy. We're not sure if that was because it didn't have enough sugar in it, or there was too much water in it due to either the fruit or the coconut milk. We're considering it a work in progress that has potential. Now, let's talk about the science. The somewhat unexpected beauty about doing this in the jar is that it's really easy to observe how the ingredients change, specifically after mixing. We didn't technically add an ingredient from this step to this step, but the ingredients have completely transformed. The texture is different, and there's a huge difference in volume. So why? What did the mixing do? Well, guess what? It actually added an ingredient to the ice cream. Not one that's on the recipe, but a really important one. Air. It has a noticeable difference in volume because there's little bubbles of air suspended throughout the cream mixture, causing it to take up more space. And texturally, it behaves and almost looks like a solid. That's because technically it's a foam, also known as a colloid. Essentially, we have bubbles of one state of matter, a gas or air, suspended in another state of matter, the milk and cream, which is a liquid. And guess what? While it's not normally with this method, all ice creams include some method or step that adds air to the ice cream. Usually it's churning. This helps the ice cream get its light, fluffy texture. Learn more about that in our other video on ice cream and air. One other thing, remember how we said we've been testing this idea all summer? Seriously, we have. In June, we made an ice cream recipe that uses salt and ice to freeze the ice cream, and we wanted to make a no-churn ice cream so you could compare the two methods. So we tried out different methods, but we really wanted to avoid one ingredient that is generally used in most no-churn ice cream recipes, which is sweetened condensed milk. It's thicker and creamier than regular milk, which is why it's usually used, but it's also really sweet, and you can't control the amount of sweetness in it. So we tried evaporated milk instead, which is similar, but doesn't have that sweetness. And that worked, but then the rest of the recipe was just kind of clunky. Like, it was this gigantic bowl, and we were trying to do a personal serving, and it didn't look very appetizing. So we just kind of left it and decided to come back to it later when we saw this amazing idea on the New York Times cooking Instagram account to use a mason jar, and it just clicked. So we adapted their recipe, and now we encourage you to adapt ours. And let us know in the comments how you change and improve and tinker with it.